हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ हितेश विश्वनाथ चार्य, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री एट एस एन जे बी श्रीमान सूर्योदय जैन कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी चांदवड नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नॉन स्टेरॉयडल एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी ड्रग्स। द लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एनएसआईडीज एंड देयर एसएआर। In the last session, we have discussed about the inflammation, pain, and fever. So, this is a classification of NSAIDs. They are classified as non-selective COX inhibitor, differential COX inhibitor, selective COX inhibitors, and certain drugs are there with having analgesic, antibiotic action, but with poor anti-inflammatory action. This is a chemical classification of that. This is again the chemical classification with their example. Coming to this. Salicylates. The salicylates are formed from salicylic acid by esterification. SAR of salicylate. This CH group here, if you reduce it to the amide, having the analgesic action but eliminate the anti-inflammatory properties. So CH group is essential for the activity. This OH group should be adjacent to this CH group for maximum activity. Any substitution on this ring result in decrease in activity, or you can see the halogenation of this ring enhances the potency as well toxicity. Substitution of aromatic ring at 5 position of salicylic acid increases the activity, example diflunisal. So these are the example salicylate, aspirin, sodium thiosalicylate, salicylamide, diflunisal. This is the 5 position containing phenyl ring with the fluorine benorylate. So aspirin is the major drug. It acts by inhibiting the COX-1 as well as COX-2. It carry out the acetylation at serine 530 residue in the active site of COX-2. When this aspirin metabolized to the salicylic acid, that causes a gastric irritation and bleeding. Coming to the other drug, phenamides. These are N-aryl anthelic acid derivatives. This is the anthelic acid moiety. Here the COH group is essential for activity. Replacement of COH with any other having ill effect on the activity. Substitution on aromatic ring here decreases the activity. Anthelic acid derivatives, this anthelic acid moiety are active. This is 2 amino benzoic acid. If you substitute this third or fourth position using active compounds, 2,3 disubstituted appears to be most active. The NH moiety here of anthelic acid appears to be essential for the activity. If replace this NH function by any other group, likewise that reduces the activity. Monosubstituted, this is a monosubstitution of N-aryl ring. Example, flufenamic acid gives a more active compounds. These are the examples of the phenamic acid, mefenamic acid. This is the flufenamic acid. You can see here the monosubstituate here with the CFC. Another class, indole and indole acid derivatives, that is aryl alkanoic acid. Indomethacin structure contains this indole ring. Increase in acidity of this carboxyl group increases the acidity. Amide anions are inactive. Aryl acidic structure, this is aryl indole ring and acidic acid. Essential for the activity. Substitution at 5 position here with the methoxy or any other group becomes more active than on certain indole rings. N-benzoyl, this is the N-substitution benzoyl ring, and again with the fluorine or chlorine or any other group, likewise are the most active compounds. Alkyl group at this position, second position, is more active than aryl substitutions. The presence of indole ring here is not essential for activity because corresponding one benzylidine, that is indene, analogs are active. Example, salindac. This is the example of salindac. Pyrolacetic acid derivatives, tolmetine and zolmipyrex. Another series of NSAIDs, phenyl propionic acid. This is the ibuprofen, the major analog of this. Substitution of methyl group here at alpha position of acidic acid side chain gives a series of phenyl propionic acid rings. Replacement of this phenyl ring of ibuprofen with two natural ring gives active compound, example naproxen. Naproxen is NAP indicating the presence of natural ring. The activity is highest with the 6-methoxy group. If you circle here, methoxy group gives maximum active compound. Replacement of oxygen bridge by carbon group yield an analog, example ketoprofen. Increase in size of circulation of this gives active compound. These are the example of that phenyl propionic acid, naproxen, this is naphthyl ring, ketorolac, diclofenac. So ibuprofen again inhibits the SCOX 1 as well as SCOX 2, that result in decrease in formation of precursor prostaglandin and thromboxane, which are the mediators of inflammation, fever and pain. Diclofenac bind and chelate both of these SCOX 1 and SCOX 2, and by that block the conversion of hyaluronic acid to the mediator prostaglandin. Another series of NSAID analog acid derivatives is also known as OxyCAMs. Analic acid or oxycam, also known as say as 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazine-carboxamide. So it is a 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazine-3-carboxamide. Oxycams are acidic compound with pKa range between 4 to 6. This R2 is generally an aryl or heteroyl substitution for active compound. Alkyl substitution, if you replace here, gives less active compounds. N heterocyclic carboxamide here generally more acidic, and that in acidity increase gives a less active compound. This is one example, piroxicam. Optimum activity you can see observed with this CH3. If we substitute here CH3, this is what N R1 we are talking about. This heterochloral system gives more active compound. Another, paraaminophenols phenols. So these are having majorly analgesic and antipyretic action. They don't have this anti-inflammatory activity. This is acetaminophen, means paracetamol. This is another drug, N-acetine, which is on metabolism, gives paracetamol. This is the metabolism of paracetamol. It is metabolized by glucuronidation, sulfonation and N-hydroxylation. By N-hydroxylation, it gives NAPQ, which is a metabolite of this, which produces the side effect, liver toxicity. So, paraaminophenol, acetyl group here that must be present for the optimum activity. The replacement of phenolic group of paracetamol, that should be the para position. That result in the formation of metabolite. It's a more toxic here. If you replace it with toxic group, no substitution on this phenyl ring, that gives the maximum activity. Another, cyparazolone, antipyrin is the major drug of this category. Another example, aminopyrine and dipyrone. This is the antipyrin here, simply H. If it is substituted here by the other group, gives aminopyrine, dipyrone. These are having analgesic, antipyretic and anti-rheumatic activities, but they cause organal substance as a major side effect that limit their use. So these are modified into 3-5 parazolidine diones. The major drug of this category is phenylbutazone. The metabolite of this phenylbutazone is oxyphenbutazone. This is a phenylbutazone example. It contains 3-5 parazolidine diones. Beta dicarbon system have analgesic stability. Dicarbon function at 3 and 5 position enhance the acidity. N-butyl group here at the carbon 4 gives maximum activity. N-propyl or analogs are also active. Replacement of one ring of nitrogen, the oxygen gives isoxazole and that also gives activity. 3-hydroxy-N-butyl reduces possesses non-reducoric activity but decrease anti-inflammatory activity. Substitution of para position of this one of this ring does not drastically affect the activity. That should be para-hydroxy derivative, example oxyphenbutazone is the example. Para-hydroxy derivative oxyphenbutazone, which is a metabolite of phenylbutazone. Other things are COXIF, or you can say benzene sulfonamides. So So it is a one of the general structure of this coxy. Here you can see two this enabling one second should be the adjacent to each other for enabling activity. Para-sulfamyl phenyl group at the one position of pyrazole, higher potency and required for COX-2 selectivity. Third position of the pyrazole here, a trifluoromethyl or difluoromethyl provides superior selectivity as compared to the fluoromethyl or methyl separation. So these are known for their COX-2 selectivity. So these are known as COX-ZIB or COX inhibitors. So side effect of this drug is they cause heart attack and stroke. These are used in treatment of rheumatoid arthritis, osteoarthritis and menstrual pain. These are the example valdecoxib, paracoxib, celecoxib, etrococoxib and docetaxel. These are all benzene sulfonamide, which are COX-2 selective drugs. So when we are talking about traditional anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin, inflammation is reduced by blocking COX-2, but the protective mucus lining of the stomach is also reduced because of COX-1 is blocked, and that can cause stomach upset, ulceration and bleeding from stomach and intestine. Why? When you talk about selective COX inhibitor, these are the NSAIDs that selectively block COX-2 enzyme and not the COX-1 enzyme. Blocking this enzyme prevents especially the prostaglandin formation by the COX-2 enzyme, and that causes reduction in the pain and inflammation. Other miscellaneous agents, nabometone, nimesulide and tetraglufenac. This is nabometone containing naphthalene, betalfestine, nabometone. Nimesulide is exam structure, and this is tetraglufenac. This nimesulide is having liver toxicity effect. So this is summary what we have discussed up to this. We have discussed non-selective COX inhibitors, selective COX inhibitors, preferential COX inhibitors and analgesic antibiotics with poor anti-inflammatory actions. Hope you have enjoyed this session. Thank you.
Yeah.